3:11 p.m. I've been in most of the day. I've had no post today, which, you know, no news is good news. But I do tend to check the mailbox a few times a day because you get junk mail put in there. You get, you know, people putting things in there, pizza leaflets. So I like to keep my box clean and tidy. I like to keep my box clean and tidy. But when I came back from walking Max, I mean, it was really, really quiet on the field for a nice sunny day that it is. A few people walking their babies in prams around the field. And I was able to let Max off the leash, and he had a good run around. He's tired. He's quite contented sat there. So when I came back, there was this in my postbox. I live in Rochester, which is a historic city, and it's the, here we are again. Dear Sir / Madam, and if I need any information about this letter, I can contact Jamie Webber of the Department of Regeneration and Culture, Environment and Transformation Events Team, Gunwolf Dot Road, Chatham, Kent, Jamie Webber. Rochester Sweeps Festival, 30th of April, 1st and 2nd of May 2022. The way I'm feeling at the moment, I probably won't go to it at all. I just feel terrible. Just leaving my flat is a big, huge step for me at the moment. This is telling you about the road closures. We thought it might be helpful to give Rochester residents and traders information about the proposed road closures that might affect you during the Sweeps Festival. Now, I don't own a car, so it won't affect me. I can't drive. In order to facilitate the safety and welfare of all involved, the following roads will be closed between 9 a.m. and 7 p.m. on the dates above. Where possible, we will endeavour to accommodate access up to 10 a.m. for residents and traders. The High Street between its junctions with Corporation Street, Bridge End and Star Hill, Almond Place with the junction of the High Street, Bishop's Walk with the junction of the High Street, Eastgate Terrace with the junction of the High Street, Eastgate Court with the junction of the High Street, Rochester, Crow Lane from its junction with the High Street, Blue Boar Lane with the junction of the High Street, La Providence with its junction of the High Street, Northgate from its junction with Cathedral Garage Car Park to its junction with the High Street, Bowley Hill from its junction with St Margaret Street and the High Street, including the Precinct Junction, High Street with its junction with the Esplanade, Castle Hill from its junction with the Esplanade, the entire length to include Castle Hill Court, permitting resident access only, and E. Paul Lane, entire length. Leading up to and after this event, Castle Hill at its junction with E. Paul Lane will be closed at intermittent times to allow for vehicle access and or egress to the castle grounds. Mostly this will be managed under stop work system of traffic control. Please note that the road closures on or leading to the High Street will be considered as hard closures and will only be lifted to allow access for the emergency services. Therefore, please ensure that you have arranged for deliveries and collections to be made outside of these dates and times. Festival waste. Can I also remind traders that the festival's refuse service is solely to deal with the extra rubbish generated by the public and it's not for general traders' waste collections. Outdoor stages. Please note that we will have entertainment areas throughout the High Street and stages at certain locations. We will endeavour to keep the volume of music at a reasonable level, but if there are any issues, please bring this to the attention of event stewards on the day. As ever, we apologise for any inconvenience that these road closures cause and look forward to your valued cooperation and assistance that allows these events to safely take place. I hope you find the above information helpful However, if you require any information, please do not hesitate to contact Jamie Webber, the events manager of Medway Council. I don't live in Liverpool, do I? There's a certain person that's been having some issues with a gentleman called Paul. I live in Rochester, not Liverpool. Anyway, enough of that, because I know who I am, I know where I live, and so do they, and making out it's me when it isn't, that's their problem. Right? I am not a transgender, I'm not intersex, I'm a straight female. Okay? I don't put up posts about other people. I put pictures of Rochester up on my YouTube channel. I don't talk about people and plaster their name on posts on YouTube. That's not me. I fight for the safety of children and the safety of animals. That's all I'm concerned with. I don't want to fight with anybody. Alright? But when somebody attacks the colour of my skin, my race, my gender, and my sexuality, then I get cross. So before you tar somebody with someone else's rubbish, can you come to me, please, face to face, or email me and tell me what your problem is? Because I am not transgender. I'm all for people being themselves, but me and myself, I'm a straight female. See you later.